The view that Joseph Smith killed two men in a gun battle against an armed mob comes from John Taylor, who was present with Joseph at the time the events occurred. He, however, instantly arose, and with a firm, quick step, and a determined expression of countenance, approached the door, and pulling the six-shooter left by Brother Wheelock from his pocket, opened the door slightly, and snapped the pistol six successive times. Only three of the barrels, however, were discharged. I afterwards understood that two or three were wounded by these discharges, two of whom, I am informed, died. It would be easy for Latter-day Saints to just accept the assertion that two men died since he came from John Taylor. The argument of self-defense can be appropriately made as Joseph Smith was defending his life along with his friends. The question is, did this really occur? Did two men die? If true, why don't we know their names by rumor or from obituaries? Critics never offer the names of these two dead men. The reason for this is that nobody died. If one looks at what John Taylor says, he says, two of whom, I am informed, died. He did not see the bodies of two dead men, but he was told of this by an unknown source. John Taylor does not question the validity of the source. He may have accepted it to be true, but that does not mean the source was correct. This is called hearsay evidence, which is often rejected in courts of law. Hearsay is defined as unverified, unofficial information gained or acquired from another and not part of one's direct knowledge. If the source was wrong, that could explain why there is no record of the deaths of these two men and their names. Based on what is known, Joseph Smith did injure three or four men. Their names were John Wills, William Verres or Voorhees, and William Gallagher. Though injured, they did not die of their wounds. Non-Latter-day Saint historian Colonel John Hay recorded, Joe Smith died bravely. He stood by the jamb of the door and fired four shots, bringing his man down every time. He shot an Irishman named Wills, who was in the affair from his congenital love of a brawl, in the arm, Gallagher, a southerner from the Mississippi bottom, in the face, Voorhees, a half-grown hobbledehoy from Bear Creek, in the shoulder, and another gentleman, whose name I will not mention, as he is prepared to prove an alibi, and besides stands 6 feet two in his moccasins. Darlin Oakes and Marvin Hill in Carthage Conspiracy, the trial of the accused assassins of Joseph Smith, wrote, Wills, Verres, and Gallagher were probably named in the indictment because their wounds, which testimony showed were received at the jail, were irrefutable evidence that they had participated in the mob. They undoubtedly recognized their vulnerability and fled the county. A contemporary witness reported these three as saying that they were the first men at the jail, that one of them shot through the door killing Hiram, that Joseph wounded all three with his pistol, and that Gallagher shot Joseph as he ran to the window. According to Hay, Wills, whom the Mormon prophet had shot in the arm, was an Irishman who had joined the mob from his congenital love of a brawl. Gallagher was a young man from Mississippi who was shot in the face. Another source says Wills was a former Mormon elder who had left the church. Hay described Verres, Voorhees as a half-grown hobbledehoy from Bear Creek, whom Joseph shot in the shoulder. The citizens of Green Plains were said to have given Gallagher and Verres new suits of clothes for their parts in the killing. Until something credible comes forward that two men died, names would be nice. The current evidence shows that it did not happen. Thank you for your time.